The Pleco Chinese Dictionary app is one of the most popular and useful apps for Chinese learners. You can think of it as a Swiss Army knife for looking up unknown Chinese characters, words, and entire phrases. Many of you guys already know and treasure the little Pleco fish on your phone. But even if you're using the app already, you might find this video still interesting, as I will also discuss some of the premium add-on features it offers and show you how you can get them cheaper. So stay tuned to find out how it works. Da jia hao, and welcome to Mandarin Language. My name is Matt, also known as Tianzi. And if this is your first time watching, this channel here is all about helping you to make faster progress with your Chinese studies. Here I'm going to show you the currently best study materials, tools, and strategies. In other words, it's all about how to learn most effectively. If this is what you've been looking for, why not consider subscribing and activating the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future episode. But back to today's topic, which is all about the Pleco Chinese Dictionary app and how it can be your one faithful companion on your learning journey to Mandarin Chinese proficiency. So without any further ado, let us switch right to my smartphone and I'll show you exactly how it works. All right, welcome back on my phone. You can see the Pleco Dictionary app in the top left corner. Let's open it up. And here you can see the main input screen. So we can search for an English word, a Chinese character, or its pinyin, depending what you're looking for. Let's start with something simple. So let's say we want to translate the English word phone into Chinese. And it's actually the very first entry I was looking for. So I tap on that. Now what you can see here is the basic dictionary entry. And it's actually from several dictionaries. So we got the PLC dictionary, the CC dictionary. These dictionaries are already installed by default. You can also download additional dictionaries if you're looking for a more comprehensive one or one which is more specifically related to your field of study. You can also see the characters being displayed both in simplified and traditional. We got the pronunciation written in pinyin below. And we can also tap on the little speaker icon for an audio sample. Below, you can find a couple of useful taps. Let's check those out for a moment. If you tap on stroke, which by the way is a paid feature, you will be shown in which stroke order the characters are actually written. This can be quite useful for complex characters. And chars will give you the composition of the words. So in this case, the word for phone is composed of two characters. The first one being dian, for electricity, and the second one for hua, for talk. So basically, the word for phone in Chinese could be translated into something like electric talk, you could say. Below, once again, you can see the traditional character writing, which is still being used in Hong Kong and Taiwan. And we have some alternate fonts. Now, if we click on the tab Words, we see all the dictionary entries that contain the word phone, such as phone number. And sentence will give you some example sentences. This can be very useful if you want to see how the word is used in context of a full sentence. This makes it easier for you to grasp its proper use and remember it better. Now, if we go to the side menu, we will see all the other features this app offers. And some of them here are not in the free version. Some paid features, for example, include the OCR, which is the optical character recognition, as well as the reader and the flashcards. Let's go to a very powerful feature, which is the live OCR. And
This is going to activate my phone camera here. And I have a book with me here, preparing for the Chinese language exam. So I try to scan the characters here and tapping on pause afterwards. And now I can simply tap on the individual characters and words to learn more about the meaning and pronunciation. This is a very powerful feature if you want to make sense of any Chinese character written in a book, for example. It is a much faster way to look up characters than using traditional methods. This is very powerful stuff. You can also apply the OCR to images. Here I just scanned a page of the book I was just using. And with a frame, I select the parts of the text I want to scan. Tap on Capture afterwards. And now it shows me exactly the characters I was just scanning. Now I can again tap on individual characters and words to learn more about them. Or tap on the speaker icon to hear the pronunciation. Or listen to the entire text. This OCR, the optical character recognition, I find extremely useful. Yeah, so this is it. These are some of the very useful features the Pleco app offers. If you're interested in the OCR scanning, if you think that could be useful to you, go right to the website. And I have the website right here. Here you can learn more about Pleco's numerous features. And if you're interested in purchasing them, I would actually suggest you to buy it via their website. It's about 20% cheaper, and this probably has to do with the App Store otherwise charging you on top for every purchase you make directly inside the app. So you can get them much cheaper when buying through their website. A link you can find in the description below. They also have additional dictionaries here, in French, Italian, Spanish, German, as well as some advanced dictionaries, specialized dictionaries, and even ebooks. I haven't tried those myself, but I think especially here the HSK ones, if you want to prepare for the Chinese language exams, could be quite interesting and useful, because you can simply tap on the words and it will instantly show you its meaning. So in my opinion, it is much better than working with books these days.
I hope you enjoyed this video and learned a few new things along the way. If you like this kind of videos, please give it a like and let me know in the comments below which of the numerous Pleco features you find most useful for your studies. Finally, don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you want to learn more about how to learn Chinese more effectively while having more fun in the process. Until next time, 下次见.